You can hardly imagine you can do that with the sneaker. I'm just holding it with one hand and it's so flexible. You can just see. You can do that with a slipper or a flip-flop, but not sneakers. Is Nike 5.0 better or 3.0? Let's find out. Going on, people. Today we have the NIKEFREE runs with us, and it's a versus video. So before we start, make sure you follow me on Instagram. I'll put the link here below. And if it's your first time on my channel, make sure you subscribe if you're into sneakers. Without further ado, let's get it started. Nike designers saw university students practicing outside in the field, and they were barefoot, mind you, and they were just cooling down actually after a workout session outside their university, Stanford University it was. Nike designer, they thought that, you know, the university coaches, people in the management, they'll be interested in athletes wearing something new from Nike. Back in 2001, they started working on it. Free run research was all about foot movement of athletes. So the foot movement is always in an S shape. If you can see, it moves like an S shape. NIKEFREE was first launched in 2004 and 5, and it was the most minimalist sneaker of the age at that time, and still is. NIKEFREE is the minimalist sneaker, as you call it, the barefoot sneaker as well. Numbering level states basically the cushioning levels of the 5.0, the 3.0. It is the height from the ground. The higher the number, the higher the cushioning from the back heel and the front toe. The retail of both these NIKEFREE runs were under $100. I paid like £95 back in 2012-13 when I bought these from Foot Lockers. Nowadays, NIKEFREE you can easily find out on StockX under $100. You can find these anywhere. Both the soles basically give you a barefoot feeling when you're running. I'm pretty sure most of you have the idea how NIKEFREE feels overall. But if people who don't know about these NIKEFREEs, if they want to go and grab a pair, I would recommend to go on easy on these, because they can cramp your feet. They can cramp your shins if you're straight away if you start running in them. So I would recommend try these on, walk for a while, you know, a mile or two, or give it a week, I would say, to max, and get the feel of it, get used to it, and then start running it. NIKEFREE 5.0 is 20mm higher with more cushion compared to the Nike 3.0. It's just like you're running on the surface without any shoe. They're so light, they're like hardly 200 grams or 250 max. They're really, really lightweight. If you compare both of these from the front, they look quite similar. There is more padding in Nike 5.0 as compared to 3.0. As you can see, these are a bit squishier from the top as well as on the sides, and it has more cushion underneath on the heel as well as in the midsoles. That's why they say 20mm more extra cushion in Nike 5.0. And I've been using these for, you can say, over 7-8 years. Pretty durable. The heat runners, the marathon runners, or the track runners, it's a daily running shoe, I would say. Let me know in the comment section what do you think about today's episode and the comparison today. Whether you wanna go for the Ultra Boost, the Vaporflies, or you'll fancy the NIKEFREE runs. I'll be back with another sneaker very soon. Till then, you take care. Bye-bye.